One of the reasons why I'm making this video today, because a lot of people, they put their trust in flesh. They put their flesh, their confidence in the flesh of man or the flesh of human beings. Now in Peter chapter 1, Peter, 1 Peter 5, 7, it says, casting all your cares upon him because he care for you. And I tell people, no one cares like Jesus Christ. When I say no one cares like Jesus Christ. And the reason why I say no one cares like Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ, glory to God, cares about you and about me. Amen. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. No one cares like Jesus. Because if you're in a situation and you call your parents, you call your pastor, you call the president, you call people, my friend, they might not come. But when you call on Jesus, he might not come when you want him, but he always on time. So no one cares like Jesus. And that's why he say in Matthew 11 chapter, hey, glory to God, 11 chapter verse 28 through 30. And he say, casting all your cares upon him because he care for you. He said, come unto me, all he that heavy laden, and I will give rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light. No one cares. Now he say, come. When he say, come, he's inviting you. When he say, come, his arm is still stretched out. When he say, come, he say, glory to God. He say, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come and sup with him. So when he say, casting all, that mean all. Hey, glory to all. It don't mean some of your cares. It don't mean, glory to God, you just concerned about the big thing. God's concerned about the small things. And a lot of times we just give God the big things and that the small thing. But the Bible said the little foxes that spoil the vine. So if you, my friend, is an individual that go through trauma, if you are an individual that go through crisis, if you're going through a mental breakthrough, the Bible said casting all your cares upon him because he cares for you. No one cares like Jesus. Amen. That's why when Jesus Christ was handing the book, he told them the purpose why he came. My friend, Jesus Christ didn't come for money. He didn't come go to God to master anything, because he's master. When he was trying to make Jesus Christ become king, the Bible say he went away because he already king. They don't need to make Jesus Christ king. So when Jesus Christ In the book of Luke, let's talk about the book of Luke. The reason why Jesus Christ came, and a lot of people think Jesus Christ came for popularity. He came to be a prince. He came to be a king. No, he's already popular. He's already the potentate. He's already prince. He already had what? So he didn't come. He come. Why he came, preacher? He came. And listen to what the Bible say. And the Bible say, and he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as the custom was, he went in a synagogue. He went to church on a Sabbath day. He went to God and stood up to read. Hallelujah. So Jesus Christ came, hey, glory to God, and he came to the church. He came to the synagogue. He didn't come, glory to God, for no money. He didn't come, glory to God, to excite us. He come for a purpose. That's why I tell people, Jesus cares, and I care. Hey, because I'm a mailman delivering a mail of careness. And the Bible say, hey, glory to God, and they will deliver unto him the book of Isaiah. The book of Isaiah, when he had opened the book, he found a place where it was written. Now, the place was written because Jesus Christ came to fulfill the scripture. Jesus Christ, glory to God, cares about you. Amen. No one cares like Jesus. I tell people, Jesus Christ spelled out like Jesus. He's joy. He's everlasting. He's a savior. You take your problem to the Lord, and he the sweet smelling savior. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's a soon coming savior. When you look at Christ, he's a coming one. He's a high priest. He's the right one. He's the righteous of God. Hallelujah. He's the great I am. He's the S, the soon coming king, the sovereignty, the supreme one. And T, he's time. He's the terrible one and he's truth. Hallelujah. So the Bible say, and they were delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he opened the book, he found the place where it was written, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Hey, glory to God. Because he anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. That's the reason why, my friend, I'm a preacher. I'm not a preacher for popularity. I'm not a preacher for profit. I'm not a preacher to get people, glory to God, property. I'm a preacher because God have anointed me to preach the truth. The truth hurt. Paul said, am I your enemy because I tell you the truth? Truth hurt, my friend, but truth heal. Truth give you high hopes. Hallelujah. Truth make you hear truth. And truth make you go to the high tower, and the high tower is Jesus Christ. Hey, glory to God. And he said to preach the gospel to the poor. My friend, Jesus Christ didn't come to preach the gospel to rich people, because the rich people already think they're rich. So I need a gospel. But the poor people, they need to hear the gospel. He has sent me to heal the broken heart. That's why I tell people, Jesus, no one cares like Jesus. He come to heal the broken heart. To preach deliverance to them that are captive. People that are captive, there are people that are walking around, hallelujah, behind bars. Even though bars is not iron. Hey, glory to God. Bars are captivity of slavery of demonics. People are slavery of homosexuality. People are slavery of lesbianism. People are slavery of pornography. People are slavery, my friend. Listen, a white man is not a slave master. You know what a slave master is? Satan. Satan, the Bible says, the God of this world have blinded a mind that they may believe the glorious gospel to save them. That's why I tell people, no one cares like Jesus. Hey, glory to God. And the Bible say, my friend, he goes, and to recover sight to the blind. There are a lot of people have eyes that still can't see. Look at the blind man. The blind man say he was blind from birth. And Jesus Christ healed him. And when his mother and his father supposed to agree that my son was blind, the Bible say they took side with the Pharisee because they love the praise of men rather than the praise of God. So they say, this is our son, but high receiver sight we know not. Hallelujah. And the blind man had to stand his 2 feet by himself and say, yes, I am the same man. But it say that we are Moses' disciple. Hey, glory to God. There are a lot of people that are men disciple, but I'm Jesus Christ's disciple. I belong to Jesus. I belong to Yeshua. I don't know what you call him. You might call him Jehovah. You might call him Yeshua, but I call him Jesus. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. So the Bible say, my friend, hey, glory to God. He preached deliverance to the captive and to recover sight to the blind. And to set at liberty them that are bruised. Jesus Christ come to set you free, brothers and sisters. And the reason why you're not free, because you're in captivity of religion. Now I'm talking to this guy on my channel. And he say that I'm ignorant. He say that, glory to God, he say all these things because I love the King James Version Bible. But I'm telling him, I'm not here to debate. I'm here to reason to you about righteousness. I'm here to reason to you to make you escape from hell. And a lot of people go to church, but they're going to hell. And the reason why they're going to church, hallelujah, because they're going to hell because, my friend, they're in religion and don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ. There are people that are unsaved and still going to church. They're sitting on the truth. And it's still in the lies. Look at the centurion. The centurion, when he killed Jesus, he said this is a righteous man. But he got a late confession. I want you to realize, my friend, I'm not here to look friends. I'm not here to finance. I'm not here for you to make me famous. Hallelujah. But I'm here going to God to tell you about the Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us day our daily bread, and we forgive our debt, forgive our debt. Lead us to temptation, but deliver from evil. For thine the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. So I'm here as a mailman. I'm here to give you the mail of salvation, of telling you no one cares like Jesus. Don't put your trust in flesh. Don't put your trust in the arm of flesh, because the Bible says, curse the man that put his trust in flesh. The flesh is mess. I said it, the flesh. The Bible said, don't have no confidence in the flesh. Amen. No flesh shall glory in my presence. So no one cares. I said it, no one cares like Jesus. And I'm going to tell you, my friend, hey, glory to God, our house situation was burnt down. Hallelujah. Not burnt down, but we had a flood. Hey, glory to God. And for 1 month, we was in an apartment. We was in a hotel. And no one came to our rescue. Hey, glory to God. And the only person came to our rescue is Jesus Christ. He gave me the knowledge. He gave me the wisdom of don't panic, but praise. Don't worry, but worship. Hey, glory to God. But no one came to our rescue. Hey, glory to God. I thank God for my insurance. I thank God for my adjuster. Hey, glory to God. But I thank God that God has given me the spirit, hey, glory to God, of not panicking or worrying, but worshiping and praising Jesus Christ. That's why I tell people, I'm making a video, my friend, through experience, I'm telling you, no one cares. Like, people don't have discerning spirit. Amen. What I said, people does not have discernment spirit. If you have discernment spirit, don't override your discernment. If God say go and bless this person, don't override it and say, Lord. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. Because look at who was it? That when God, when Jesus Christ told Cornelius, Cornelius, that Saul is coming to you. Amen. And Cornelius say, Lord, but he persecute the church. But Jesus Christ say, he's a chosen vessel. Amen. Cornelius didn't override it and say, Jesus, I don't mean no harm, but you wrong about this man. But Cornelius did what Jesus Christ said. And a lot of people that have discerning spirit, God tell you to bless this person with $1,000 and you override it and say, Lord, I don't have. You have it. If you didn't have it, God wouldn't tell you to bless that person. And a lot of people, especially my family and my wife family, they have discerning spirit, but they want us to ask them. I know the Bible says, ask shall be given unto you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But a lot of time, we don't have to ask. God have touched you to touch somebody's life with finance. Hey, glory to God. With supplications. Amen. And you override it by not listening to the Spirit of God to say, give. Give and it should be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down together, when men give into your bosom. It's a blessing to give than to receive. So I tell people, no one cares like Jesus. Because a lot of people, they have discerning spirit. I know they do. But they override the spirit and don't give. But the Bible say, God love a cheerful giver. God don't love you when you giving sad, when you giving complaining. God love a cheerful. That's what the Bible say, the sheep and the goat, and how the sheep go into everlasting, hallelujah, everlasting life, and the goat going to everlasting damnation because they didn't give no necessity. When I was hungry, he didn't feed me. When I was naked, he didn't clothe me. Was in hospital, he didn't visit me. Hey, glory to God. Was in prison, he didn't visit me. As much as you did it unto me, you did it unto me. So I'm telling people, no one cares like Jesus. That's why we can't put our trust in man. We can't put our trust in money. We can't put our trust in machine. We can't push our trust in nothing. But I put our trust in the master of the universe. And the master of the universe is not He-Man. Glory to God. The master of the universe is Jesus Christ. Glory to God. So no one cares. Glory to God. Like Jesus. Are you listening to me, brothers and sisters? Put your trust in God. Hallelujah. So Jesus Christ came to set at liberty them that are bruised. If you are bruised, Jesus Christ can heal you. What I say? If you are bruised, Jesus Christ can heal you. Amen. Because he said that, glory to God, I come to set the captive free. Stand fast in a liberty where Christ had made us free and be not entangled with the yoke of bondage. Hey, glory to God. Amen. Amen. And it said to preach the acceptable year of the Lord, and he closed the book and he gave it to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all of them were open. All of them that was in a synagogue were fastened to him, and he began to say unto them, this day is scripture fulfilled in your ears. I'm saying to you, brothers and sisters, that no one cares like Jesus Christ. My friend, Jesus Christ care, he concern, and he's compassionate. Hey, glory to God. Amen. No one cares like Jesus Christ. Can I pray for you? Father God, bless this person right now. Oh God, give them the faith to know that no one cares like Jesus. Oh God, let them know that Jesus Christ is the arm, not flesh. He's the arm that's still stretched out wide. He still wants you to come to him and be heavy laden, and he will give you rest. He wants you to take his yoke upon you and learn of him. It's time for you to be taught by God. Bless this person. Let them trust in the truth and trust he go to God in time. And the time is Jesus Christ. Bless right now. And just now pray. Oh God, bless this person to trust more in Jesus Christ and stop trusting in their pastor, in their parents, and in the Pope, which have no hope. Bless right now. Just now pray. Amen.